You're listening to When Christians Speak Online Talk Radio, broadcasting out of the Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. Today's voice crying out in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. When Christians Speak is dedicated to lifting up the name of Christ Jesus and spreading the good news.
Host Reverend Pat Randall, and I'm joined by my guest host, Brother Charles White. Say hello,
Good afternoon, brethren. Good afternoon.
Praise God. Praise God. So we are continuing on our journey with this title, Christ as My Example, for verses, Christ is My Life. So this has been a blessing for both
yes.
Charles and I.
Amen.
And, we've been able to just look at scriptures and just discuss what the Holy Spirit is showing with us. And, you know, we're all on this journey together. We're all headed toward the same destination. We
yes.
all go through the same struggles. There's nothing new under the sun unto man. Glory to God. But God knows it all. He's the only wise God. He is the only one that can keep us from falling and present us before the throne. Hallelujah, in all of its glory. Well, before we get started, I am going to pray so
yes,
that
Lord.
We are headed in the right direction spiritually. Glory to God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Father, we praise you this day. We glorify your name. We say that this is the day that you have made, and we choose to rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you because you've already been here. You've already prepared everything that we need. We thank you for the right perspective this day.
Thank
we
Jesus.
Thank you that we can see our Lord and Savior, Christ Jesus, as he is, because as
Hallelujah.
He is, so are we in this world. We thank you for life and breath today, to be able to take this breath that you gave us and to honor you with it, to praise you with it, to glorify
yes.
your name with it. Father, we lift up this broadcast today. We know that truth only comes by the Holy Spirit. So Holy
right.
Spirit, take full charge and dominion over this broadcast. We thank you for your anointing. Glory
yes.
to God, because we know it is the anointing that breaks the yoke. So
Hallelujah.
I thank you for every listener who will be listening live and who will be listening later to the podcast, Father God. I thank you that they will hear a word just for them, because you are a personable God, and you are very detailed, and you love us. And even though there are billions of us, you know us individually. And you know what our needs are. And you love us, and you created us uniquely.
Yes, God.
And we just thank you for that. So have your way. Have your way in this broadcast, and we will give you all the praise and all the glory and all the honor, because only you alone deserve it. So we thank you. Thank you. We love you this day. And it's in Christ Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Glory to God.
Amen. Amen.
So here we are. You know, this is actually the third broadcast you've been with me on, Charles.
Yes, it's been so exciting.
Yes. And he actually, well, this is the last one that he'll be joining me here on the East Coast. But I'm hoping that once he hits the West Coast that he'll find time to come back on the air, glory to God, and just share what the Lord is doing. Brother Charles, he's an actor, and he's been involved in an acting studio, and he's actually on his way back out to California, just pursuing what God is calling him to do in this time. Amen. And to use the gifts that God has given him to honor him and to spread the good news of the gospel. So we're going to keep Charles in our prayers as he goes forth. And we know that out in Hollywood, there's a lot of warfare going on, which is warfare is going everywhere. But we know that there are specific strongholds that are out there in California. But we thank you that God has given him the power to dismantle.
Yes, Lord.
Those things that have been erected by the enemy. Glory to God. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to we're going to stop and we're going to have just a little commercial about the upcoming show listings, and we will be right back, and we're going to jump into this topic, Christ
All
is
right.
my life versus Christ is my life. Praise the Lord.
We invite you to join us every Tuesday at 7 p.m. for His Abounding Grace Show with Minister Vanessa Williams. Every Wednesday at 7 p.m., Challenge to Change, where real transformation begins with you. That's with Pastor Paul Morgan of Chosen Generation Ministries out of Richmond, Virginia. Thursdays, live at 12 noon, join Reverend Pat Randall for Declaring the Finished Work. Reverend Ray and friends are here on Friday nights at 7 p.m. with the Joy of the Lord on Friday Night Joy. Saturdays, Alabaster Box at 7 p.m. with Prophetess Carla Johnson. And Bread of Life with Reverend Ray on Sundays at 7 p.m. For more information, go to our website, www.whenchristiansspeak.com.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Glory to God. Because of who you are.
Because of who you are.
Lord, and I give you honor. I just want to mention that the chat room is open. So for you chat room users, welcome. Welcome. Amen. And while you're out there, if you have any prayer requests or even any comments, let us hear from you. God bless you.
Amen.
Okay, so I figured we could start off by just kind of reviewing.
Right.
Last week, some of the things that we shared. Okay, Charles, you want to start?
Sure. Holy Spirit, just please, just stir up the gift in me and just take over. I know last week we talked about, again, Christ being the example versus Christ the lifestyle. And I know that I gave the Greek word for example is tupos, T-U-P-O-S. And the definition given is, we said, was a figure, a copy, a model, and a type. And then I gave the Greek word for lifestyle, and for this particular situation, what we're talking about, I used the word opa, basically meaning to live and work, which is a very common phrase, word used in the Greek vocabulary, opa, again, which to live and to work. And what we talked about throughout the last couple of weeks was basically saying that Christ is more than the example because of the finished work. And the lifestyle versus the lifestyle which we are endowed with to live, basically, and to walk this walk of faith because of his finished work. So there is a difference between saying Christ be the example versus Christ the Christ the lifestyle.
Amen.
Definitely two different sides of the spectrum there.
Amen, amen. And one of the things that we shared last week is that in the scriptures, you know, as we move through our walk in the Lord, that there are levels of revelation, because we enter into a growing process. We enter into a kingdom. Now, we've been translated from the kingdom of darkness into this kingdom of light, and we don't have the experience, and we don't have the wisdom and the knowledge and the understanding coming into this kingdom of light. So we enter into this growth process, and right. There are levels of revelation that we go through. In 2 Corinthians, it says, "And we all, with unveiled face, beholding the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the image from one degree of glory to another." So as we keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, as we use the written word of God, as we use our worship and prayer time, as we use our prayer time to fix our eyes on Jesus, in beholding who he is and beholding his glory, we begin to be transformed into his image.
Right.
Because whatever you're spending your time focusing on, it starts to become a part of you.
Great. That's wonderfully said. And it goes back to what I believe I mentioned last week when I said that it is with the mind that we serve the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Having the mind of Christ as to expel the idea of the term example. We don't copy his mind. We possess it and we lay hold of it.
Thank you,
and
Jesus.
With that being said, as far as lifestyle is concerned, going back to the Greek word opa, having the mind of Christ affects our motivations, our intent, our desires, our actions, and how we respond.
Amen. Amen. And when we start our life off in Christ, we do start off as looking at him as an example, because he's
right.
The pattern. He's the pattern that we have, and we've never lived this life before. So
right.
We do need a pattern that's set before us. But as I said, we move from glory to glory, so we can't just stay there, because the word of God says that Christ is our life, that as he is, so are we in the world.
So are we.
And yeah, but if we stay stuck, and religion will have you consumed with yourself,
right.
And your behavior, and so you're always trying to alter this behavior and try to follow this pattern, and it becomes a labor, it becomes an effort, it becomes a work,
right,
in which we can't always maintain.
That's
in,
so true.
in our lives, and some people just throw up their hands and says, you know, I can't do this.
Right That goes back to the term when we mentioned example, perpetuates the idea, denotes the eventuality of stepping outside of the mold or the example we're trying to follow. And we basically, at some point or other, because we are human, have the human element, we fall short and we miss the mark. Even though that the grace is always working on our behalf as believers, we need to understand that example versus lifestyle, the lifestyle endows us with the reality of Christ's finished work.
Amen. Amen. And when we move into the revelation that he is my life, and
right.
actually that is the only way. The scripture in Romans 8 where it says after Paul goes through the whole struggle of this war between his flesh, which is that carnal nature, and the mind of Christ that wars against one another, his spirit man, he moves to this place where he's saying, well, you know, how do I get through this battle? And that first verse in Romans 8, you know, it talks about, therefore, now there is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus.
Right.
And condemnation is judgment. So the judgment for this sinful life was taken and has already been judged and has already been condemned in the body of Christ. And so now that I died with him, was raised with him, amen, and seated in heavenly places with him, the life that I now live, I live it through him, the one who loves me. I live it through him. And so when I fall short, when I slip back into, you know, because we've all had that, especially in when you're first beginning to, and then even after you've been there years, you can end up in a place where you slip back into an old habit or an old pattern.
Right.
An old response,
right.
An old way of thinking, which is sin, because, you know, doubt anything that is not of Christ is sin.
It's sin.
That's it. So, I mean, that's how pure God's law is. That's how holy he is. So the only way that we can capture this is to embrace this life that we have.
Right.
We have to move into a place where we take the word of God, and as Charles was saying, renewing our mind.
Right. We have to understand that Christ is so much more than an example. And the lifestyle, because the world is only going to know who we are by the love that we give. And that's only possible through the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Acts chapter 17, verse 28. For in him we live and move and have our being, as certain also of your own poets have said, for we are all also his offspring. So that when I read that scripture, that lets me know that there's more than just copying Jesus Christ, copying his behavior, copying what he said and what he did. It becomes a thing of making it, like we like to say in Christendom, if I can say that, is a personal relationship.
Amen.
We have to be in him and he has to be in us, which again goes back to what I said earlier about being endowed with the ability to live a lifestyle that perpetuates the glory of God through us on the earth versus the mindset of Christ as an example, tupos, T-U-P-O-S, that's the Greek word.
Amen.
Where we keep Christ as an example, and sometimes not even accepting who he is, but using him as a prototype to get us out of trouble or to emulate, in a sense. You know,
Amen.
Believing, but not believing, if that makes sense. It separates. So again, my point is to make the distinction of an example is something that we copy or we have an idea of versus a lifestyle, which is something that we more or less are endowed to live and to be. and to be
Amen.
And to have our being, basically.
Amen. When you were talking about believing, belief, it's one thing to believe, and
right.
it's another thing to know. To
mm-hmm.
know in the sense of being aware of. You know, I
right.
can be aware of the Word of God.
Amen.
And not believe it.
Right. The
I
Word
can,
of God says
I,
even the demons are, even the demons believe.
Amen. Amen. But even the word of God is alive. And it's alive because the Word of God is Jesus, is the Christ.
Hallelujah.
That is the living word.
Thank
you. And the scripture also tells us that if everything that he did when he was in just his bodily form in the earth, if it all could be written, all the things that he had done that the into books, the world would not be able to even contain the volumes because it
right.
is so it is so much. And so we have to rely on the Holy Spirit that lives
right.
on the inside of us to reveal this truth. Before Jesus left, he said to us that he had to leave so that the Comforter could come.
Thank you, Jesus.
And in John 14:26 it says, but the Helper, the Holy
right.
Spirit. He's the helper. You know, we were talking about that earlier, Charles, the
yes.
Holy Spirit, the helper, that, you know, we set off, we get into frustrations about things because we don't look to our helper. He's like
Amen.
Right there, called alongside. He's been called the helper.
Right.
And we don't seek the help until we have exhausted our human
right.
effort. And then we turn to the Lord, you know, I can't do this.
Right, right.
But the Lord is wanting us to move past that, past
Amen.
Past trying to do it in your own strength, and
right.
start to look to him first.
Hallelujah.
Before you even start to move out on anything. He says, come to me, all ye
yes.
and are heavy laden.
Right.
And we may have to continuously use that word in our lives when we find ourselves moving, you know, into that place. Like I was sharing with you, Charles, that I had, you know, because things were getting a little busy
right.
in my life, that I was reverting back to a pattern of trying to get things accomplished, trying to get it done in an excellent way, and you know, just consumed with it. And what happens is, you know, I was leaving him on the outskirts.
Right.
I
right.
was aware that he was there.
Right.
I'm always aware that the Lord is present with me.
Right.
But sometimes we can be so busy that he is left on the outskirts. He's almost like observing what we're doing as opposed
right.
to him living through us and being a part of what we do in our daily lives.
It's definitely relational. And we have to be consistent and aware that Christ. So this is why we have to be careful when we use the term example, because example, again, denotes an idea, a copy, an image, and
mm-hmm.
it subtracts from the reality that Christ is more than all of that, because there's a level of involvement and relationship that occurs. And the interesting thing about it is, if we want to go into Scripture and we want to, let's look at, well, I'll refer to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20.
Mm-hmm.
Now then we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God. So, in a sense, we are the examples. Christ dwells in us. We are to live a life that is holy enough to pour out God's glory unto the earth. And ambassador, the Greek word for ambassador, is presubio, P-R-E-S-B-E-U-O. And ambassador is someone who has the authority given by a higher authority to govern a certain area or a particular government or a particular group of people. So referring back to Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20, we as ambassadors, we're the representatives. We are to engulf ourselves so much into Christ and in what he has done for us that we are the examples. We as the believers are the examples. We are walking, living epistles.
Amen. 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 To the world.
To the world
that, you know, they can read us and see, and when they read us, they're reading the living word. It's
living
Christ.
Word.
It's Christ
right.
in us. It's Christ
right.
in us that they are living. I'm going to read Galatians 2, start in verse 20. It says, I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me.
Yes.
And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith. Amen. We'll come back to that. We'll talk about faith and we'll talk about laboring to enter into his rest.
Right, right, because it definitely is a labor.
Yes, amen. Let me see. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. I do not nullify or make void the grace of God. For if righteousness were through the law, and the law, whenever we see the word law, we know that there is some sort of requirement of works.
Right.
You know,
right.
It basically equates down to you do this, then this will happen. But if you do
right.
not, then this is going to happen to you. So, and so it's saying if righteousness was through the law, then Christ died for no purpose.
Right.
So if it's based upon me
Jesus.
Being able to obey everything perfectly, then why did Jesus die?
Right, right.
If I'm thinking that it's up to me, then why did he die? Why did our Lord die? What was the purpose of that?
Right.
And the other thing is recognizing that we're talking about a transaction that took place by the living God.
Preach.
The all-power, all-knowing God. Just like when Abraham, the covenant that was made with Abraham, which was a covenant of grace, God put him to sleep.
Mm.
So if you go back to the, I don't want to go through the story, listeners, but if you go back to Genesis and read about this covenant that was made, that God made with Abraham, when it was first set up, it was set up in a way that two people would make a covenant.
Right.
And they would split open these animals almost like a sacrifice and lay them and walk between them. And it was like a blood covenant kind of thing. But what I want to focus on is that God did not rely on Abraham to be the covenant keeper.
Mm-hmm.
He made the covenant and he became the keeper of that covenant.
Right.
And that was a foreshadowing because the Old Testament is the stories in the Old Testament, the things that are there are a foreshadowing of what is to come. And so when Jesus came, which is this final redemption of man, I mean, this is it. The redemption
mm-hmm.
is final. Well, he said it is finished when he was on the cross.
Right.
He didn't say it's almost done. He said it is finished.
It is finished. The ultimate reconciliation.
Right. So
all debts
finished. How can I, as mere man, undo what God has done?
Right. Right.
That's why nothing can separate us from the love of God. Nothing can, no height, no depth, nothing. No angels, no created things, nothing can separate
right.
us from the love of God. He has securely placed us in himself. We are fully justified. And when we were talking about redemption before, because we were redeemed by Christ's life. He gave his life. And he became, the reason he took human form, because he was representing man on the cross.
Right.
He came, he represented us, and he took, he who had no sin, took on the sins of the world, so that man could be redeemed back to God. And in the scripture where it says that our life is no longer ours, but his.
Yes.
And which is a good thing. Because, you know, when we owned our own lives or thought we owned our own lives, we did a poor job with it. Because
right.
we didn't value our own lives and the things,
right.
the decisions that we made and the things that we subject ourselves to is a clear indication that we didn't value our lives.
Well, how could we when our minds haven't been renewed?
Amen.
When your mind is not renewed, your actions are going to obviously reflect upon what the mind dwells and thinks on. So when your mind is not Christ-centered, when you haven't possessed the mind of Christ, you haven't laid hold to it, then of course the flesh is going to do all manner of things. It's going to be capable of all manner of things.
Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God.
It's in my spirit. I want to make sure that the listeners understand the differentiation between Christ the example versus Christ our lifestyle. I know it's so much a part of our culture, our vernacular, our the way that we have been taught. We're not saying that Christ is not the center or the focal point. But when we say the term example, like I said earlier, I've said it several times already, when you say example, you separate yourself from Christ in the sense that you put him in a place where he becomes somewhat unrelational. And we step into the idea of, okay, Christ is an image that, again, we have to imitate or emulate or copy, but we know in our human element we fall short of that. So if we take that understanding and juxtapose it to the idea of Christ the lifestyle, having Christ be the center of our life, accepting who he is, accepting our role and our authority as ambassadors, as the examples, then we begin to see that Christ is much more than an example.
Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. And so what you begin to, as you begin to shift your perspective from
right.
yourself
right.
to Christ, that he is your life, that's who you are now.
Right.
He was the forerunner. He's like the first fruit, and now he's reproducing after his kind.
Yes. Right. Exactly. Exactly.
He's reproducing after. So we are, it says Christ in us. Christ
in us.
And not only in us, but it says as he is, so are we. We are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. So there's no separation anymore.
Right.
And
that's key. I think that sums up a lot of what we've been talking about. There is no separation anymore.
Praise God. Praise
God.
There is
no separation anymore.
There's no separation anymore. But we're going to take a break right here. We're going to come back to this very important discussion.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I know the Lord wants to see us walking in liberty. It says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there
right.
is liberty. And to understand what that really means, liberty doesn't mean, oh, I just do what I want to do. I mean, that's the world's version, of course. You know, I do what I want to do. I say what I want to do. If I feel like it, I do it. And just because I feel like it must be all right. You know, we're not talking because you're still in bondage.
Right.
You're in bondage to your flesh. You're in bondage to this world. You're in bondage to the influences of the world. And more importantly, you're in bondage and under the influence of the prince of this world, who is the devil.
Mm-hmm.
A real enemy. A real enemy.
Right.
Okay. Anyway, so before I start up again, Charles, I'm going to... I'm going to play Break Every Chain by Cosmic Cobbs. Glory to God. And we will be right back with you. Amen.
All righty.
Come on, use your key. Use your key.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain. Woo! To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Come on, Timothy. There is power in the name of Jesus. Oh, there is power in the name of Jesus. Every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Oh, break every chain, to break every chain, break every chain.
That's it, there is power.
There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, you declare it.
There is power.
There is power.
There is power
in the name.
In the name of Jesus.
We know where it is to break every chain. Break every
chain. Glory to God. My mic was still muted, so
yeah,
I have to remember to unmute my mic when we come back in after a break. But I was just saying, reiterating what that song was saying, that there's power in the name of Jesus to break every chain. And that power lives in us.
Yes, God.
The power that breaks every chain lives in us.
Right. We got to activate it. We got to activate it.
Yes. We don't have to wait for something outside of ourselves.
Right.
to transpire. You don't even have to wait for someone to lay hands on you, because the power is in you. You can lay hands on yourself. You can speak life over yourself.
True.
Praise
God.
That
is scripturally true. Amen.
Praise God. So here we go. Here we go back. I mean, this is something that we really, Charles, we really want to lay hold of in our lives. And the enemy has been so cunning and crafty, basically within the church. He has to work from within, because that's how, if you want to destroy something, you need to get inside of it and start to spread either doubt and division and, you know, all those things.
Right.
You know, those evil works that actually don't belong in the kingdom of God, not in the body of Christ. And he can do that wherever the flesh is in operation.
Mm-hmm. That's the entryway, right?
Right. And that is our carnal nature. It's the nature of man. And so he will work wherever that is in operation. And so as long as we are basically using, you know, our flesh, it doesn't mind. It loves doing works, and it likes doing that kind of stuff, as long as it's in control.
Right. Well, I mean, we like everything God has created, the adversary has a perverted version. So we were created for a work,
mm-hmm.
and to do a work on the earth, so and in the earth. So, of course, when we're operating in the opposite of what God has created us to be and to do initially, the adversary, if and when, is going to take advantage of that, especially if we're ignorant of his devices.
Right, and that is why it's key that we move from this Christ is my example into Christ is my life.
Christ is my life. Only what we do for Christ will last. Scripture tells us that. Only what we do for Christ will last.
Praise God. Amen. So this is a battle that we are in. And most of it is taking place in our mind.
True.
It's the real battlefield, you know, between our carnal thinking, the thinking that is that residual thinking that we have from the world, from the conditioning of the world. We've been conditioned to think a certain way by the world, and we actually have to, you know, the scripture that tells us to take every thought captive and bring it into obedience to Christ. And we have to be very deliberate in our thought life. We really need to examine and say, you know, is this the life of Christ? Is this, you know, and we have the Word of God, that the written Word of God. Now, just think now, the first believers, they didn't have the written Word of God. They didn't have a Bible. There were letters that were sent, and everybody didn't, you know, it wasn't like they sent out, like today, you know, a ministry will send out 5,000 letters or 100,000 letters. No, this was one handwritten scroll that was sent out. So everyone didn't get a personal letter.
Okay.
with this revelation that Paul or Peter or Mark or John. And so how did they live that life?
Mm-hmm.
These are people who stood up against persecution.
Right.
Especially when Rome was in power, they were a lethal weapon when it came to the body of Christ. And all manner of horrid persecution was being engaged in against the body of Christ, being thrown to lions and being lit up as human torches. I mean, just all manner of things. And it was the life of Christ in them that gave them the power to endure.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. As you're talking, there's a scripture that I don't have memorized off the top of my head, but the Holy Spirit is ministering to me that we have to learn how to trust in God's grace and his mercy.
Mm.
We do. We really do have to, because our flesh is so prone to be in coercion with the adversary to just to not fulfill God's plan for our life. And it's so funny because when you were talking about how it's a work and we have to labor, I was grabbing my notes. And it's true. We have to labor into his rest. We have to fight the good fight of faith.
Amen.
We were talking about that earlier. And
yes,
we have to not be afraid, like we talked about earlier, to have confidence and expectation for good.
Mm-hmm.
Because God is good.
God is good. We are, the world would tell us, okay, you know, something good happened, but just wait for the other shoe to drop. You know,
right.
We have this negative
conditioning.
Yes, that we expect the worst. I mean, the first thing when things go awry or things are happening that are negative, the first thing that our first initial response a lot of the time is to expect something terrible.
Right.
As a result of this thing. And so it is hard for our little minds to comprehend just how good he is, because he is so good.
So good.
You have to, I mean, in the beginning, I was almost like, it can't be this good.
Right.
My mind was like warring with me. It's like,
right,
nothing is this good. I mean, it just can't be this good. It just cannot be this simple.
Right.
And to think that someone would do everything for you.
Mm-hmm.
Like a parent does for a child.
Right.
You know, while that child is with you, you are doing everything for that child until that child matures and steps into that full-grown, matured role as an adult. And we are his children. And it's interesting because there's like this, these two things that are happening actually at the same time. We are his children and we are utterly dependent on him as a child, you know, because Jesus said, unless we become as a, have the faith of a child, we can't enter the kingdom. We have to become like children, right, to enter into the kingdom. And that's having this understanding that it has been done for you, that you are, you know, you are taken care of. I'm taken
Amen.
Care of Father.
Amen.
But then at the same time, we're also full-grown sons of God. which means we are joint heirs. We have the same inheritance as Christ Jesus.
Praise God.
We have authority and power that has been given unto us. It's almost like, you know how they used to knight the knights of the round table, and
right,
all of a sudden you're this courageous knight, and you've been knighted, and it's like, so you've been given a certain authority and a certain power. Yes, an ambassador. Exactly. And so when it comes, I believe that, Charles, you know, as I'm talking, I believe that in our personal lives, as we're moving through this life, that we are childlike, expecting the Lord to provide for us, to do for us, that it is by faith. It is by faith. Glory to God. But when it comes to the devil and the works of the kingdom of darkness, we are full-blown ambassadors with authority, authority and power. That,
yes, God.
At the same time, we become this mighty general in the army.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we take command. We take command when we walk into environments where
there's
oppression and depression and repression going on. We step in with a higher authority than the dark power that is at work.
Right.
We step in a higher authority, and we take dominion of that atmosphere.
Right.
We take dominion. We take charge. So we've got all of this wonderful. It's absolutely wonderful, all that we have, that the Lord has done, that he would love us so much. That's why we're more than conquerors.
He said
we were conquerors. He said we're more than a conqueror.
More than conquerors.
More than a conqueror. We're beyond.
I mean, I said it earlier. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the whole wide world. If we dwell on that and act upon that, oh, my Lord.
Amen. Amen. One of the things that I shared in my devotion, and it was coming out of a personal experience.
Right.
Couple of weeks of just being challenged, or actually having a battle with my flesh, because I was, you know, my flesh wanted to go back to being in control and being busy, you know, this and doing that, and you know, because you know, for your flesh, it thrives on accomplishing things and looking as if I've done this, and in order for it to feel good about itself.
Right.
But God has already identified who we are, so we don't need accomplishments to identify who we are, even though we have been equipped for good works. Glory to God.
Right.
And so I had gotten to that place, and it's, you know, you start, there's a little shifting that takes place, and if you don't catch it at the onset, just a little bit of slippage, you know, if it happened drastically, you, of course, you'd notice it right away.
Right.
But, you know, just a little bit of slippage, just a little slide a little bit here, slide a little bit here, and then you find yourself way over here. And so I found that I was actually taking in stress in my life, and that's definitely, we don't have to be stressed out. That's what the
world
is. But what we have to be careful of, which is why our focus, we have to keep a strong focus on our lives in Christ, because this world, there's an energy going on in this world. And this energy that's always all around us, when we wake up in this world and we move, we step out of our house and we're in this world, and there's this energy in this world that is all around us, but it's going in the opposite direction.
In the opposite direction.
The opposite
so
direction of the current of the spirit.
So true. The Holy Spirit. Yeah, so true.
Yeah, and because the masses are moving in the wrong direction, you have to swim upstream of this.
Yeah, there's opposition for sure.
Exactly, exactly. And so what we have to do in order to have the strength and the power, because it's not our strength and it's not
right.
our power to do this, we have to abide in him.
Amen.
And that's back to that scripture in John 15. I'm going to read that. It says, abide in me and I in you.
Right.
The branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine. Neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine. You are the branches.
That's a perfect scripture.
Whoever abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. Now that's kind of for us to take in, because apart from him, we can do nothing.
Right.
Because
right.
we like to think that because we accomplish, you know, and we're constantly surrounded by people who have made a name for themselves, and they built this great empire, they have all this money, they da-da-da. But though all of that stuff is temporal, it will not remain. As you said earlier, only what we do for Christ shall remain.
Right. Right.
Only what we do for Christ shall remain.
So true. God bless.
And we have stories of children who have been heirs to these huge estates, and it has ruined their lives because
mm-hmm.
what they inherited wasn't eternal.
Right. Right.
See, what the Lord gives, it adds no sorrow.
Hallelujah.
That's what I was
thinking.
Mm-hmm. What the Lord gives adds no sorrow. So we've got to, as we're moving through this, we've got to stay aware of who we are. Of who we are.
Amen.
Of who we are. The Lord loves us. He loves us, and we're able to do this. I mean, the enemy, your flesh will try to convince you that you can't.
Of course.
The devil will try to convince you that you can't.
Of course.
But today, the Spirit of the Lord is saying that you can, because I live in you.
I live in you.
You may have trials and tribulations, the Spirit of the Lord says, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world.
Right.
Overcome the world.
Right. I promise you, once you make Christ more than an example and allow him to infiltrate the secret places of your heart and endow you with the understanding that the Holy Spirit is here to empower you to live a victorious life, you will understand and know and recognize the bondages that have been broken off of your life.
Amen. Yes, and what we have to remember also is that, you know, this toiling and this sweating over the brow.
Right.
That entered because of the curse.
Right.
That is a curse. But once you enter the kingdom of God, And the only way you can come in is through Jesus Christ. There's only
through
one.
Christ way. Himself, the man.
The way. One truth.
All right.
Life. That's it. There's only one life, and he's it.
Mm-hmm.
There's only one truth. He is the truth. He's the sum
right.
total of truth. Just thinking about that.
I know.
Total.
Because we spend so much time making Christ this untouchable, this far off deity that we strive to be like, and not understanding fully that once we accept him, that he's with us. There's a relationship, and we have to understand that the work is already done. The work is already done. The work
it's
is already done.
Already done.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we fight the good fight of faith.
Right. We just press towards the mark.
Amen. Amen. And we speak blessings and not curses for our lives. That we are what we're saying. We're saying what God says about us. We're speaking that over our lives, over the lives of our loved ones, our children, our spouses, our friends, even our coworkers. I mean, the scripture tells us to even pray for our enemies.
Right.
To love those who spitefully use you.
Right.
And there is no way that your flesh is going to be able to do that.
No.
It has to be the life of Christ. There's no way that you can, in your own strength, try and imitate that.
Right.
Either you have it.
Or you don't.
You know what? Yeah, that actually just made me think about this other scripture. I think it's in 1 John. It talks about love. God is love. And if you he who loves God loves his brother, loves God. What's that? 1 John.
7 and 8. Verse 7 and 8.
Oh, let me see. Here we go. 1 John. Let me see. It's just it. Okay, yeah. Okay, 1 John 4.
Oh, 1 John 4.
Okay. I'm going to start in 12.
Okay.
No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us. So a lot of times I think we reverse it and we think that we have to love in order for God to abide in us. But
right.
Let me just keep reading this verse, this passage of scripture. By this we know that we abide in him and he is in us because he has given us of his spirit. And we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. Whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him. And he in God. Okay, so that's what happens when you first, in just right off the bat. Once you confess that Jesus is the Son of God, right off the bat, believing that he is the Savior, glory to God. He gave his life for the forgiveness of it. God abides in you.
Hallelujah.
And you in God. That immediately, that transaction takes place.
Right.
It doesn't take you 20 years for that to happen instantaneously after that confession.
Right.
Now, you got to fight the good fight of faith.
Right, right.
Glory
because you
God.
Do have an adversary.
Yes, you do.
Kill, steal, and destroy.
There you go. And he really wants to kill you now because now
right.
you're no longer on his team.
Right.
Okay, verse 16 says, so we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us.
Amen.
You got to know that he loves you. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God. And God abides in him. So because God is love, if we abide in God and God is abiding in us, then love is abiding in us because God is love. That's amazing.
It is amazing.
Yeah.
That is very amazing.
Isn't that amazing? So you don't have to try to love because love is already there. You got to believe that it's there. Activate the power of love in your life. You have to believe it by faith that that has occurred. He has not given you a spirit of fear, but a spirit of love.
Jesus of Nazareth. This is sweet to my soul. Oh, my Lord.
My goodness. Okay. So I know it's blessing me, too, as I just go back through this. Because truth has to get deeper and deeper down in us. And the more you review, even the same scriptures, it gets deeper. And you need this thing down in your heart.
Right.
Out of the heart, the tongue confesses. I mean, all the issues in your life have a lot to do with what's going on in your heart.
True.
In your heart, okay?
Well, the Word of God says to guard our heart because out of it are the issues of life.
Yes, to
so
guard.
So that's just about what you just said, yes. A lot of the things that are going on in our lives, whether it be good or bad, are because it's all predicated on the heart, the condition of the heart.
And so then verse 17 says, by this is love perfected with us, so that we may have confidence for the day of judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Because as he is, so also are we in this world.
Mm-hmm.
There is no fear in love.
In love.
But perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment.
Yes.
So that is so key. For fear has to do with punishment.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Punishment and fear are connected.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
And whoever fears has not been perfected in love.
Yes, God.
God's love for you. You haven't been perfected in it.
Jesus.
We love because he first loved us.
Right. Right.
It's all him. It's all him.
Thank you, Jesus, for your word. Thank you for your word.
It is truly finished.
Hallelujah.
It is truly finished. I think we should just take a moment and pray.
I agree.
Yeah, this is a moment. Father, we praise you and we glorify your name. We worship you and we honor you. We thank you for the word that you are releasing through the air. Today, we know that when it's released, it can cover thousands and thousands and thousands of miles. It can go in many different directions into many households and into the heart of those who are thirsting to know the truth in this life. You are the truth, Jesus. I thank you that you are making yourself known in a way for believers, in a way that they've never seen before. Open up the eyes of their understanding so that
Hallelujah.
They see more of you. Glory to God. And realize that you are in them and they are in you, that there is no separation. That this perfect love that you are, that's living on the inside of them, will cast out every fear in their lives. That there is no more condemnation, so they don't have to fear judgment. That they can freely walk in this redemption.
Right. Yes, Lord.
Glory to
Hallelujah.
God. And for those, Lord God, who have not yet given their lives to you, they're in the pre-Christian, pre-salvation mode, but they're looking. I thank you today, Lord God, that they see you as you really are.
Right.
See you as how you moved through the earth when you chose to take on the form of man.
Hallelujah.
How you came not to condemn, but to save the world.
Right.
That your love for them was so great. You were filled with compassion and filled with mercy. You came as a healer.
Hallelujah. You
came as a deliverer. You came as a friend.
Yes.
I thank you, Lord God.
Hallelujah.
That they are able to open their hearts and embrace you and allow you to just walk in and take control of their lives.
Yes, God.
And that their life now becomes your life.
Hallelujah.
That you live in them. That they can be at rest because they'll know that no weapon formed against them shall prosper.
Right.
Because the greater one lives in them. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Bless
God.
Lord, we glorify your name, God.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Lord Jesus, thank you and praise you, Lord God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
you. Just thank and praise you, Lord God, for those who are listening, for those who have been in the body of Christ and those who are new to the body of Christ, Lord God, that they have a desire, a hunger, and a thirst that you will fill, Lord God, that you will just allow them to know and to learn and to understand more about who you are and your love for them, Lord God, your love for us. Lord God, we just thank and praise you, Lord God, for the endowment of the Holy Spirit, that we are ambassadors, Lord God, that we are representatives, that we are the examples of what you would have us to be, Lord God, to exemplify the glory, Lord God, the grace and the glory, Lord God, to infiltrate the earth, Lord God, that your kingdom, hallelujah, Lord God, will be established, Lord God.
Thank
we thank you, Lord God, and we just ask those things in Christ Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. He's worthy. I just feel that you should sing some sort of worship song or something right now. Just take a
hallelujah.
Little something. Thank you, Jesus.
I love you, Lord. And I lift my voice. To worship you, oh my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you hear, and let it be a sweet, sweet sound.
Hallelujah. 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 Bless the name of the Lord.
Bless the name of the Lord. Bless God.
Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord, for he's worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised.
Yes, he is.
So I just want to decree over your lives today.
Hallelujah.
I have the confidence that Jesus is in you.
Hallelujah.
And that he is greater than anything that can come against you.
Bless God.
I am confident that you are a new creation in Christ.
Abba,
and that
Father.
And so are you in this world. I decree that
yes,
you
God.
Are blessed with everything that is needed for life and for godliness.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
That you are fully equipped with spiritual weapons, able to
Jesus.
Pull down strongholds. Glory to God. I decree that the love of God, which is perfect, resides on the inside of you. I decree that from this day forward that you will be moving in a supernatural boldness
yes,
and courage in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, Lord.
That the enemy will not be able to hold you captive in any area of your life. I thank you for a strong power of discernment
yes.
to come over you, that you are able to see the enemy before he even approaches your territory. You will see him afar off.
Thank you, Jesus.
And you will send your word, glory to God, to dismantle and to confuse him and to have cause him to scatter. Came in one way, but he'll leave scattering in seven different ways.
Yes, God. That's your word.
God, you will confound the enemy.
That's
you
your
will
word.
Confuse.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. You will grow in your worship.
Hallelujah.
The intimacy will deepen. I thank you, Lord. I thank you. I thank you that this decree goes forward and it accomplishes that for which it has been sent. And it has been sent in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We praise you, Lord.
Yes, God.
Thank you, God. We thank you, God.
Amen. 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 Yay and amen.
We're so blessed that you joined us for the broadcast today.
Bless
praise God.
God.
Tomorrow night, we've got Friday Night Joy with Reverend Ray and friends. The joy.
Reverend Ray.
God, friend. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Reverend Ray and friends, Friday Night Joy.
Glory to God. Glory to God. And remember to go out on our Facebook page. If you haven't been out there, go check us out and like us while you're out there. One
yes,
Christian
please.
Speak Talk Radio.
Right.
Amen. Yes. Glory to God. So we are grateful, 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 grateful. So, I'm grateful. I'm grateful.
Amen. Just yes, I'm full.
This has truly has been a blessing. Today, and it was what I needed to hear, Brother Charles.
Me too.
I needed to be reminded. I need to deepen my relationship with the Lord. I need to keep the truth before me about who I am.
Right.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God, and not allow any type of spirit of discouragement to come in. Amen, amen. Just trusting and knowing that my steps are ordered by the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to
God.
Bless the Lord. Do you have any final words before we...
I just want to say that my heart has been stirred. The Holy Spirit is definitely moving. This is a time for God's people to just open up their ears, their eyes, their heart of understanding, and to recognize that God has good plans for us. And I just thank and praise the Lord that I had an opportunity to participate while I'm here. And Lord willing, I'll be able to participate further when I move over to the West Coast. And I'm just blessed to be a blessing. And I know that God is doing a work, and I'm excited about what he's doing in the lives of his people.
Praise
amen.
God. Amen, amen. So God bless you all. Return to your afternoon just filled with the fire of the Lord. Glory to God. Reignited, charged, glory to God, like an electrical current, hallelujah, that just hits the atmosphere and just spreads all over the place. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So God bless you all. Amen. And thank you, my brother, for joining me these past several weeks. You have truly been a blessing. Amen.
Amen. Be blessed.
You're listening to When Christians Speak Online Talk Radio, broadcasting out of the Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. Today's voice crying out in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. When Christians Speak is dedicated to lifting up the name of Christ Jesus and spreading the good news.